Hi, my name is Keith Cooper, No Flight Images, and in this video I'm going to address a question I get asked a lot. It's based on a lot of reviews I do. It's what's wrong with modern printers? What could be done better in modern printers? Now, I'm going to concentrate more on better quality printers. So typically that's 13 inches width upwards, including things like this, the giant great Epson P5300 I'm testing at the moment, and larger printers as well. Now, this isn't exclusively to large printers like that, because I know some printers like the Epson 8550, which is a 13 inch ink tank printer, there's a 8.5 inch or A4 version of it, the 8500, which is almost the same thing. Essentially, I'm concentrating on printers which I think are the ones you would want for making good prints of photos and artwork. So I'm ruling out office printers effectively here, because they're office printers. They do different stuff. This is about, yeah, what annoyances do I get? Not that many, actually, when I'm testing printers. So what's wrong with modern printers? Well, not a lot. As I said, it's if you can't make a great looking print with one of today's better printers, and I'll use that rough version of 13 inches or upwards, if you can't make a good print on one of those, it's almost certainly not the printer's fault. It's your fault. It's your lack of expertise, your lack of knowledge. Before you think that's a little harsh, I include myself in that. I mess things up on printers sometimes, and I get things wrong. But this is about some of the little gripes that I think where printers could be improved, where there are still areas where they could be made better, more usable. The thing to remember about inkjet printers, and I am just talking about inkjets here, it's about evolution. About 10 years ago, someone from a major printer manufacturer said to me, well, you know, you're not going to see significant differences between printers these days because they've plateaued. The limitations of physics and chemistry, so physics, the behavior of ink droplets, chemistry, the inks, those are the real limitations. And barring big changes in there, you are not going to see revolutionary changes in inkjet printers. Now, there's lots of other things go on with an inkjet printer apart from that that make it easier to use, let it produce better results. So, first up, what about the inks? Are we going to see any big changes in inks? No. It would be nice if dye black inks were spectrally even, so that they were equally dark across the spectrum. It would reduce metamerism changes when you take particularly when you try and do black and white prints on a dye based printer. You take a print into a different lighting conditions and it gets a slight color tint or something like that. That's something that could be addressed. That's a chemistry thing. I see no great rush. It's been a problem for years. With pigment inks, it's all about the pigments themselves, which are tiny bits of pigment, typically encapsulated in something like a resin or something like that. Now, sure, there may come chemistry, physics changes there that change the characteristics of pigments, but we will get more of the same. It's not going to be massively different. You're not going to get a change away from the basic CMYK ink set with all the extra inks added. Extra inks, yeah, you can add extra inks. It gets easier with advances in design of print heads, but it's still an expense. All that pipe work and all that stuff moving liquids around, it introduces complexity. Complexity introduces cost. Comes down over time, but still basically, you know, bigger, better printers tend to cost more. Yeah, that's just the way it is. Now, I said this, it's an evolution. There's nothing fundamental about it. What other aspects of inks could be improved? Well, if you're going to have a clear coat ink, give good control over that clear coat ink so that it goes in the places you want it to go. I notice that some implementations don't put the clear coat on paperwhite areas in the middle of an image, which would be a nice option to have. If you wanted to say, and there's a print here, there are one or two very white areas in this, where if there was a clear coat on it, there isn't in this printer, there might not be some clear, and that might show up. So just some more coat, but these are just tweaks. These are nothing serious about it. There's no, nothing sort of big, oh, they're doing this wrong or something like that. So I go back to the original thing, what's wrong with modern printers? Not that much, you may think, but there's still areas, as I said, could be improved. There were paper handling. Now, if there is one area that in my reviews I find issues. Now, these are not sort of things going, don't buy this printer or something like that. These are fairly minor things, although some of them can be annoying. Paper handling. I'd like to see better paper handling. Now, it turns out this particular printer here, P5300, based on the P5000, has superb sheet paper handling. I have no problems whatsoever on it. But then, this is a big, expensive printer. I'm looking at smaller printers and, you know, all sorts. So it's both, you know, Canon, Epson, other makes as well. If you're not careful with your paper choices, you get marks, whether it be roller marks or other things like that. Now, whether that's a manufacturing issue, design issue, I don't know. But it's an area where I think there could be some improvement. It could just be manufacturing tolerances that basically things need, because often need to be improved, because often people contact me and say, I've got a printer, I've just bought this printer, it's doing such and such. Is it broken? And I said, well, if it's doing this on a brand new printer, it shouldn't, send it back. And I know that people do occasionally get broken printers. Well, not broken, but not optimal printers. This does happen. You can exchange them. It's annoying, yes, but it happens. I've had it happen here with test units and had to send ones back. So I know it happens. Doesn't happen very often, but it does happen. And if you get a printer that out of the box doesn't work properly, your first recourse should be back to either the supplier of it or the manufacturer, and that should sort things out for you. Now, paper handling, what else? I said get rid of marks. Roll paper. Well, this particular printer, this is, once again, this is an excellent printer for roll paper handling. But, you know, so it should be for how much something like this costs and the sheer size of it. It's got a roll of paper at the back here. It's got a cutter. It's got roll paper is one of those things that people think, oh, I'd like roll paper in my printer. But then when they actually use it, and I've done a video actually looking at this printer, where, do you actually need roll paper? People tend to find that their perceived advantages of using roll paper, if they've never used roll paper before, don't really stack up in the way that they'd hoped. If you were hoping that roll paper is going to save you money on paper, then you're likely to be disappointed. It might, but it depends very much on how you use it. So, roll paper. Now, here's another one. Borderless. Borderless printing. This one doesn't do it on sheets. It will do borderless on roll, because it, but only edge to edge, and it cuts. But what about smaller printers? I get people asking, does this printer, it's typically about one I've reviewed where I've shown printing some greeting cards or something like that, does this printer print borderless on custom paper sizes? And the answer is invariably no. I've not come across a printer where you could put a custom paper size into it and have borderless. I don't know why, don't know what the excuses, the reason, the engineering reasons or other. It doesn't seem something beyond the wit of design to allow, if you're going to have borderless for custom paper. If you're allowing custom paper, then what's wrong with custom paper and borderless? I don't know. On this particular printer, I know it's to do with the way the overspray ink is caught, but I'm talking about smaller printers here, ones that you might use for craft stores and that. So this goes down into the 13 and the slightly smaller printers as well. That would be something I'd really quite like to see addressed. This particular printer has a straight through print path. There's a piece of board that I printed on testing, and it goes straight through. Now, of course, you need to move the printer out, because otherwise this board would go bang straight into the wall at the back here, so I had to move the printer out. But if there's no reason not to have a straight through print path, have a straight through print path, not a slightly bent one or something like that. It depends, once again, what you're going to print. I know quite a few people have been put off particular printers because they want to put thicker media through and there's no straight path. I don't know why. Once again, it's an engineering design thing. So that's sort of mechanics of printers. In terms of their usability, the screens are getting better. The screens are getting higher resolution. If I use a printer these days and it's got a tiny little screen on it and things, it seems a bit of annoyance. I expect a touch screen. I do not want, you know, speech activated printers and things like that. I'm sure somebody will invent one in one day, but you know, the touch screen is good enough. Good design, good usability. That's what you get with modern printers. But I said, yeah, what's wrong with modern print? Obviously nothing in that respect. Minor interface tweaks. It would be nice if the printer makers ran through some of the dialogues on some of the things through native speakers for the language they're being displayed in. I still see some absolutely dreadful written stuff in printers. Don't think I've spotted anything in this one. It's good. But I come lots of other examples of extremely contorted English. Yeah, that's another issue there. What about other aspects of using a printer? Colour management. Now that's improved greatly. Printers have got better over the years in how easy this, in the amount of work that a profile has to do to get a good result from it. So printers have become more linear, the gamut has improved, all sorts of things like that. But once again, it's a steady improvement. There's nothing I can look to these days and say, well, that's wrong. You know, it should be much, much better. I don't see any changes. They're all incremental in things like this. So setting up colour management, it works. One area that is an irritation to me is if you want to create custom media settings, or even if you just want to do profiling or do anything to know what media settings mean. So if I've got a setting on a printer for luster paper, and I've got a setting on the paper for semi-gloss paper, I might have one for semi-matte paper, glossy paper. What do those different media types actually mean? There is virtually no information from the printer manufacturers over the differences between media types. Now, that's an irritation. I cannot see what proprietary information would be lost in letting me know that the ink density is slightly higher on luster than it is on semi-matte or something like that, or some other aspect of it. But that's, yeah, it's a fairly refined thing, but I did say I was going for sort of the higher quality of printing here. But it's a problem in that if you try and do anything, you've got no information. This comes through to black and white as well. Now, the black and white print modes of printers has got decidedly better over the years, but it really needs some thought and attention. I get a feel that black and white modes have been added as much by engineers as through influence from photographers. I would like to see in printers a really serious effort at making a printer that just out of the box produces stunning black and white prints. Now, maybe on a relatively limited number of media types, and it may need tweaking, but I would like to see something that actually goes, yeah, this is the printer you want for black and white. At the moment, I've got all sorts of caveats and things. This one here is excellent for it. But as I say, this is not a typical printer. It's not really meant as a typical printer. It's, you know, for heavy use and things like that, but it just happens to be good. So black and white, I want consideration to that. So what about the printer maker's software now? You could say it's free software, so what are you expecting? Well, actually, if it's free software and you want me to use it, I'm expecting a reasonably competent effort. Now, certainly both the Canon PPL and the Epson print layout software are very good. What would I add to those? Well, stuff about black and white is one thing. Control, fine control over black and white. It would be nice if they had good soft proofing built into them. It would be good if they had gamut warnings that were far better than the very basic perfunctory one you still get in Photoshop. It would be nice if there was some subtlety in it. It would be nice, and software computers are powerful enough these days that you can do it. It would be nice if printer drivers, printer software offered resampling, upscaling, sharpening options in them. So basically that's improved the software. that doesn't actually, that's actually sort of improving the software to make your existing printer work better. So there's nothing much, you know, wrong there, but I would like to see that. External software, that's really nothing the printer makers can do much about. The fact that colour management and colour accuracy reproduction from mobile devices is an absolute joke is nothing to do with the makers of the printer. Yeah, they do the best. If you want to print a phone photo on even something like this, there is software that will send the picture to it, but you've got no control. They're meant for snapshots. They're meant for people who wouldn't know what colour management was if it fell on them. Now, that's fine, that's your market, but you have to remember all these things, these improvements I suggest, and they're mostly minor tweaks. All of these improvements depend on there being a market for them. And that's an area that we as photographers, artists, printmakers, we don't understand, have access to the data for the larger printer market. So I'm always very wary of saying, oh, if only you did such and such. All these things, they're businesses, they've got to be justified. So, you know, when I ask for an ink tank printer, but a much better ink tank printer. So, as I said, you know, like pigment ink sets in something like the Epson 8550. Take the Canon Pro 300, for example. I'll have an ink tank version of the Canon Pro 300. I think that would be really popular, getting rid of those tiny little cartridges. While we're at it, can we have a higher resolution print head, finer detail on it? You know, these are just tweaks and things like that. Yeah, stuff like that would be popular, but are the companies going to do it? Not yet. Ink tanks, yes, they'll come, but not a while. I mentioned right at the start about evolution rather than revolution. I cannot say, and I keep track of all the technologies, and please, if anyone's got any ideas and comments on this, do let me know. I've not seen any potential technologies that will revolutionize printing. Printing hasn't changed that much for quite a few years. Now, the software and everything that goes around it can make for better prints. And that's why I say, if you can't make great prints these days, it's your fault. Doesn't mean, though, that I wouldn't like to see more in the way of what can be done with the printers. So a long-winded way of saying there's not much wrong with them, but a few things I think could be tweaked. I wish there was some new technology like, you know, sort of quantum dots embedded in resin or something like that that were going to make some revolutionary new pigment. Maybe there is. Maybe stuff like this is being worked on. I've not seen any evidence of it. If you've got any information, please do let me know. Likewise, if you've got any thoughts about what you'd like to see that you think is missing in printers, let me know, because I am lucky enough that major manufacturers do actually ask me what I think about printers. Now, I make no claims as to whether they take any notice of what I tell them, but it's nice to be asked. So if you've got anything, however, don't bother telling me that I'd like a large printer that costs nothing, you know, a cheap printer that with cheap ink that produces top. You're not going to get it. There is the real economics of it. And also, I'm not going into the, the price of inks and things like that. That is an entirely different matter. Did a video on it a while ago, and as I expected it would, it wasn't wildly popular with some people because I said there's no such thing as an inkjet printer scam, but anyway, that's another matter altogether. But please do let me know, subscribe to the channel, that'd be much appreciated, and thanks for watching. Cheers, bye.